أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وهو الذي جعل لكم النجوم لتهتدوا بها في ظلمات البر والبحر قد فصلنا الآيات لقوم يعلمون وهو الذي أنشأكم من نفس واحدة فمستقر ومستودع قد فصلنا الآيات لقوم يفقهون وهو الذي أنزل من السماء ماء فأخرجنا به نبات كل شيء فأخرجنا منه قدرا نخرج منه حبا متراكبا ومن النخل من تلها قنوان دانية وجنات من عناب والزيتون والرمان مشتبها وغير متشابه انظروا الى ثمره اذا اثمر وينعه ان في ذلكم لآيات لقوم يؤمنون صدق الله العظيم. You must have noted all these three ayat which I have just recited start with the same verse هو الذي هو الذي هو الذي. Now actually what is tawheed? Tawheed is that whatever is happening is in this universe. Although it is happening according to certain laws of nature. And these laws of nature, science has investigated and is investigating, knowing more and more of them, then exploiting them more and more. But the result is that the modern scientific rationalism, or if you allow me to call it modern scientific ignorance, is that we tend to believe that these things are happening by on their own, automatically. No divine will, no divine command, no divine permission. Everything happening by its own. Simple laws of nature working automatically. Thus we go farther away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are diving deep into the laws of the nature. We are knowing more and more of them. We are exploiting them. Science is advancing. And we are, you know, even conquering the space. But, you know, we are going farther and farther and farther away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here we know, Allah says it is Allah who is doing it. He doesn't say that these laws of nature which you have discovered are wrong. It is happening according to the laws. But who made the laws? And not only that he made the laws, but also is controlling. He can, you know, break the laws whenever he likes. So that is actually tawheed. You can join these things together. This is science. This we know the laws of the nature. We are investigating these phenomena. We are knowing more and more. But you know, the decisive will is of Allah. It is His command. He is doing it. هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ النُّجُومَ لِتَهْتَدُوا بِهَا فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. It is He who has made for you the stars so that you get the guidance through them in the darknesses of the land as well as the sea. قَدْ فَصَّلْنَا الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَعْلَمُونَ. And we have detailed our revelation for people who know or who want to know. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَاكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدًا. It is He who has raised you and created you from one being. فَمُسْتَقَرٌ وَمُسْتَوْدَعٌ. Then there is an abode, a lodging place, and a repository. Now the meanings of these two words, what do they connote? There is difference of opinion among the Mufassireen. Mustaqar is some place where you live. You stay long. Sort of a permanent abode. mustauda, where you keep something for some time, temporarily. There are three views among the mufassireen. Mustaqar is akhirah. The hereafter is the mustaqar. The permanent abode is akhirah, not this dunya. And this dunya is mustauda. We are here temporarily. This is not our abode. This is not permanent lodging place for us. This is a temporary stage here that we are having. The other opinion, mustaqar is akhirah, mustauda is qabr, in which you are placed for this period of intervening between your death and resurrection. So this is the repository where you have been placed. And the third opinion is that mustaqar is dunya and mustauda is the womb of the mother. There we remain for a while, for 9 months. That was a temporary place to stay. And then, you know, mustaqar was dunya, because we had to stay here, say, for 60 years, 70 years, 80 years, 40 years. So these are the three opinions. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَاكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسِ وَاحِدَةٍ. It is He who raised you from one being, one living organism, nafsin wahida, فَمُسْتَقَرٌ وَمُسْتَعْدَى. Then He has given you the permanent abode also and a temporary place of repository. قَدْ فَصَّلْنَا الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَفْقَهُونَ. We have explained our revelations for people who understand. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. It is He who is sending down water from the height, from the sky. He brings the rain. Although the water from the ocean, which is evaporating and going up, and then, you know, it condenses in the atmosphere to become, you know, the clouds, and the winds are taking the clouds far off. It's okay, you know it. There's no contradiction. But actually, this whole system is being controlled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you keep Allah along with these scientific phenomena in your mind, both simultaneously, then it is tawheed. If you just ignore Allah, it is going on by itself, and all your attention is focused on these physical phenomena and scientific phenomena, then you drift away and you just lose sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is actually going astray. وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. It is He who sends down water. فَأَخْرَجْنَا بِهِ نَبَاتَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Then we bring out with it, with this water, the vegetation of everything. فَأَخْرَجْنَا مِنْهُ خَضِرًا. Then, you know, we bring out from the earth the green crop. نُخْرِجُ مِنْهُ حَبًّا مُتَرَاكِبًا. And then we grow the grain, the close clustered grain. وَمِنَ النَّخْلِ مِنْ طَلِعِهَا قِنْوَانٌ. And from the date palms, from the space thereof, come forth thick clustered dates. Low hanging. قِنْوَانٌ دَانِيَةٌ وَجَنَّاتٍ مِنْ عَنَابٍ. And then we have created gardens of grapes. وَالزَّيْتُونَ. And of olive. وَالرُّمَّانَ. And pomegranate. مُشْتَبِهًا وَغَيْرُ مُتَشَابِهِ. They look similar to each other, but they are also dissimilar. What does it mean? You know, from one, you know, plant, one tree, the pomegranates, they appear to be very close and very similar to each other, but in taste, they are different. Unzuru ila samarihi. Look with attention ila towards the fruit that it is bearing. Is a asmara, when it bears the fruit. Vayan'ihi. And the ripening of the fruit, this process is in your, before your own eyes, it is going on. But who is doing it? Is it happening on its own, automatically, without any controller, without any creator? No. Inna fi zalikum la ayatil liqawmin yu'minun. In all these things, there are signs for those who want to believe, who have the belief. They observe this, and their conviction in Allah and His attributes increases. A scientist who is a moment scientist, when he observes all these phenomena, you know, his estimation of Allah becomes greater and greater. Oh, He is all powerful. He can do everything. He is all wise. But you know, who doesn't believe in Allah, he is knowing all these laws and phenomena and science and the laws of nature, but he is not. No, he doesn't believe in Allah, and he is not estimating Him as the omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent Allah. وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ شُرَكَى الْجِنِّ. Another form of their shirk was that they had designated to jinns to be equals to Allah. جَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ شُرَكَى الْجِنِّ وَخَلَقَهُمْ. Although Allah has created them. He created you, he created the jinns also. You are also a creator of Allah, and they are also the creator of Allah. So why do you hold them as high as associating them with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَخَرَقُوا لَهُ بَنِينَ وَبَنَاتٍ. And they have concocted for Allah sons and daughters. The Christians say that Jesus was the begotten son of God. And there had been a sect among the Jews who said that Ezra, Uzair alayhi salatu wasalam, was son of Allah. And only these people, you know, the pagan Arabs, they used to say, these deities, these goddesses, Lat and Uzza and Manat, they are daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they thought that angels are daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَخَرَقُوا لَهُ بَنِينَ وَبَنَاتٍ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. Without any knowledge. What is the basis? On what authority are you saying it? Have Allah said it so in any of His scriptures? In Torah? In Bible? Anywhere? وَخَرَقُوا لَهُ بَنِينَ وَبَنَاتٍ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ. Glory to Him. And He is far beyond, much high and exalted than what they are attributing to Him. بَلِيُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Now this is the word, you know. Creation ex nihilo. Ibda means creating without any matter. And khalq means to create something from something. Khalq and ibda' or ijad or takween, three words. Ibda', ijad, takween, they mean the same. Khalq, ijad, ibda' and takween means to create something out of nothing. This is bid'ah, ibda'. That is why we call bid'ah, that you have, you know, innovated something in religion, which has no basis, no roots. You should have some, whatever you want to do, there must be some root, there must be some basis, some source in Quran or in Hadith, Sunnah, or in the practice of the companions of the Prophet. But if you are, you know, inventing some other ceremony, some other ritual, which has no roots, which is bid'ah. In the same way, ibda was creation ex nihilo. Badiru samawati wal ard. He is the originator of the heavens and the earth. أَنَّا يَكُولُ لَهُ وَلَدٌ. How can there be a son or a daughter for him? وَلَمْ تَكُولُ لَهُ صَعِبًا. When there has been no wife for him. Either you believe in a wife also. But at least the pagan Arabs didn't believe in any wife. But as I told you, the Egyptian trinity included, they didn't call him the wife of God. But the mother God, God mother, God as father, Horus as the son of God, Isis as the God mother. And actually the Christians, you know, in the later days, not in the very beginning after Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam, but later on, they also imitated and invented this Trinity. And the Trinity originally was God as father, Jesus as son of God, and Mary as God mother. That was the Trinity. Just we have an example, you know, in the case of Ismailis. When they came over to India, and they wanted to preach, you know, their own brand of Islam to the local Hindus here, they found that they believe in 9 incarnations of God. This was an incarnation of God, Rama was an incarnation of God, and Krishna was an incarnation of God. So there are 9. They added Hazrat Ali as the 10th. Dasham Avatar. He is the 10th incarnation of God. So it became very close to their minds. It becomes very easily acceptable to them. Dasham Avatar. You believe in 9 avatars, you believe in 9, you know, gods incarnate. So, why not believe in one more? The same thing that the Christians did. To spread their dogma, they imitated the dogma that was already existing in Egypt. So that was the Trinity to begin with. وجعلوا لله شركاء الجن وخلقهم وخرقوا له بنين وبنات بغير علم سبحانه وتعالى عما يصفون بديع السماوات والارض انا يكون له ولد ولن تكون له صاحبه وخلق كل شيء. He has created everything. Everything except him is the creation. He is the creator. That's all. وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. And it's not that after creating everything, he is unaware of it. No, he knows everything. As we read, that even if a leaf is dropping from the tree, it is in his knowledge. And the darknesses of the land, earth, or in the sea or ocean, everything is in his knowledge. ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ. Now this is introducing Allah. This is, you know, Tawheed. Who is Allah? What are his attributes? As we say, آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ كَمَا هُوَ بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. Believe in Allah is nothing unless you believe in all his attributes. You know, belief in God, everybody has the belief in God. But what are the attributes of Allah whom we, in whom we believe? So the attributes of Allah, آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ كَمَا هُوَ بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. So these attributes of Allah, they are being explained one by one. ذلكم الله ربكم. Such is Allah your Lord. لا إله إلا هو. There's no God except Him. خالق كل شيء. He is the creator of all the things. فعبدوه. So what is the logical result? You must worship Him. You must obey Him totally. You must love Him from the depths of your heart. All these three things go to make ibadah. Some mode of worship to show your reverence and respect. Then love. You must love him more than anything else. And then total obedience. Three things joined go to make ibadah. فَعْبُدُوهُ وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَكِيلٌ. And he is the guardian and responsible for everything. لَا تُدْرِكُهُ الْأَبْصَارُ. Sights cannot comprehend him. Our eyes, our sight cannot comprehend him. He is invisible. Our sight cannot comprehend him. لَا تُدْرِكُهُ الْأَبْصَارُ وَهُوَ يُدْرِكُ الْأَبْصَارُ. He comprehends the sights. He is seeing you, but you can't see him. وَهُوَ لَطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. And he is the subtle one, Latif. You cannot comprehend him. He is beyond that comprehension. But on the other side, he is Khabir. He is aware of everything. He is aware of everything, but you can't know him in his person. You can't see him. You can know him only through his attributes. That's all. آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ كَمَا هُوَ بِأَسْمَائِهِ وَصِفَاتِهِ. What is his person? How is he like? What is his form? You can't see it. It is beyond your perception and beyond your conception even. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بَصَائِرُ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. O mankind, the enlightenments have already reached you from your Lord. This is enlightenment. This is how he is introducing you to Allah. He is telling you his attributes. Basair, enlightenment has come to you from your Rabb, from your Lord, from an absara fali nafsi. So whosoever sees, so he sees for himself. Faman amiya. And whosoever closes his eyes, becomes blind, doesn't want to see, faaleha. So it is going to harm him and none else. وَمَا أَنَا عَلَيْكُمْ بِحَفِيظ. And I am not a guard over you or a watch upon you. Let us wait. بند کر دیجئے آپ. And in this way we are rotating our revelations. We are changing our modes of expression. We are telling you things, the same things in various ways. وَلَيَقُولُوا. So that these unbelievers say, you have learned. No doubt you are a learned person. وَلَنُبَيِّنَهُ لِقَوْمِ يَعْلَمُونَ. Even if they don't accept, they will accept that you have learned and you are a knowledgeable person. وَلَنُبَيِّنَهُ لِقَوْمِ يَعْلَمُونَ. And so that we make it clear for those people who have the knowledge or who want to have the knowledge. اتَّبِعْ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ. Follow whatever has been revealed to you from your Lord. لا إله إلا هو. How many times it is being repeated? La ilaha illahu, la ilaha illahu. This is tawheed. There is no God except Him. Faridan il mushrikeen. And just turn away your faces from these people, the associators of something or someone with Allah. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مَا أَشْرَكُوا. Hey Allah, had Allah decided and willed, they couldn't do any shirk. Whatever sin somebody is committing here in this world, it is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the freedom of choice. If He wanted to perforce bring us to the right path, who could go to the wrong path then? So this is because for testing. خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لَيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. This life which we have given you in this world, it is a testing period. Ulzume hasti se to ubra maninde habab is neya khane mein tera imtihan hai zindagi. And for this imtihan, for this ibtila, for this trial, for this testing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the choice. You can go this way, you can go this way. Imma shakiram wa imma kafura. If you want to behave as grateful to us, okay. If you want to behave as thankless person, okay, go ahead. If He had decided not to let you go that way, you couldn't go. وَمَا جَعَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَفِيظًا. And we have not appointed you, O Muhammad, as their keeper or as their guardian. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. You are not responsible about them. You are responsible only for conveying to them the message of Allah, preaching to them the revelations that are coming to you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rest of the responsibility lies on their own shoulders. وَلَا تَصُبُّ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرَ عِلْمٍ. And don't abuse and call bad names to those deities whom they are calling or worshipping except Allah. Although they are false, but you shouldn't call bad names to them. You shouldn't abuse them, because then what will happen? These, you know, ignorant people, فَيَصُبُّ اللَّهَ عَدْوًا بِغَيْرَ عِلْمٍ. They will in retaliation abuse Allah, and they will use bad names for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this they will do without any knowledge. كَذَلِكَ زَيَّنَّا لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ عَمَلَهُمْ. In this way we have made the actions and deeds of every community seem beautiful to them. Their own religion, their own dogmas, they seem very good to them. So if you just, you know, annoy them, and if you abuse their gods and goddesses, false goddesses although they are, and they have no reality, but then they will react and retaliate, and they might abuse Allah. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ مَرْجِعُهُمْ. Then to God, to Allah, to their Lord is their return. فَيُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Then He will inform them of what they were doing. وَأَقْسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ جَهَدَ أَيْمَانِهِمْ. Now this is the point that we discussed last night in detail. And they swear by Allah the most earnest oaths. لَئِن جَاتْهُ آيَةٌ. If some miracle comes to us, if Muhammad can show us a clear miracle, visible miracle, palpable miracle, لَيُؤْمَنُنَّ بِهَا. They will definitely believe in it. Then they will accept Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Prophet of Allah. قُلْ إِنَّمَا الْآيَاتُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Tell them, all the miracles and signs are with Allah. In His command only. It is His power. وَمَا يُشْعِرُكُمْ. Now the address is turning towards the Muslims. I told you that it might have been that some of the Muslims might have thought that what's the harm if they are demanding a miracle? If a miracle is shown, maybe some of them, you know, come to believe. Or at least they will have to shut their mouths. And you know their argument will be finished. But here Allah is saying, وَمَا يُشْعِرُكُمْ. You don't know, O Muslims, أَنَّهَا إِذَا جَاتْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. That even if those miracles are shown and they have come to me, then they will never believe. Because that is not the real reason of their unbelieving. They know from their hearts, from the bottom of their heart, that this Quran is from Allah. It cannot be composed by any human being. When four times the challenge has been thrown to them, In these surahs, in Surah Yunus, in Surah Hud, in Surah Bani Israel, and then for the fourth time in Surah Al-Baqarah. وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَاتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِّثْلِهِ. And they could never dare to meet this challenge. So actually they know it by heart that this is from Allah, but they don't want to accept it. Why? then you know their position, they lose their positions. Their vested interest is gone. Then they will have to obey Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This subordination, that is not acceptable to them. وَمَا يُشْعِرُكُمْ And you can't, you don't know it. What thing will make you know? أَنَّهَا إِذَا جَاتْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ When those all signs, even if they come to them, they are not going to believe. وَنُقَلِّبُ أَفْئِدَتَهُمْ وَأَبْصَارَهُمْ كَمَا لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ And we have overturned, or we shall overturn their hearts and their sights. As they didn't believe for the first time. This is a very basic philosophical ayah of the Quran. You know, once some truth dawns on you, and your heart testifies this is true. If you accept, it's okay. If you don't accept, you reject. But out of arrogance. Knowing that this is true, this is correct. As I told you, it happens to us. Many a times, we are in an argument, we are arguing among ourselves. And during the course of argument, I feel that the point of view that he is presenting is correct. But if I accept, it means I am defeated. He is victorious. Well, I am not ready. And then I start arguing and arguing, going to the left, to the right. Although my heart is telling, no, you are doing wrong. So actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, when the truth dawns upon you, you jump at it. If you reject it, then you know the capability, the faculty of recognizing the truth will be taken away from you. This is what we call disused atrophy in physiology. You know, these eyes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to see. If you tie them up, cover them up, for about 2-3 months, the sight will be gone. Because you are not using it. This joint is to move. You put a plaster to the joint. After a few months, this capability of movement will go. It will be just frozen. If you don't use anything which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, then the capability of that thing is withdrawn by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given human beings the capacity and the capability to recognize truth. This is true. Now if you accept it instantaneously, it's good for you. Your capacity of recognizing truth will increase. But if you decide to reject what your heart has told you it is correct, then this, you know, faculty, this capability is withdrawn from you. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, نُقَلِّبُ أَفْئِدَتَهُمْ We shall overturn their hearts and their sights. كَمَا لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ Because of that they didn't believe in it for the first time when the truth has dawned on him. And actually this process reaches its climax. A man reaches the point of no return now. That is what Allah calls, we have put a seal on their heart. Now he cannot reach. He cannot go back. Because he has reached the point of no return. وَنَذَرْهُمْ فِي تُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ And we shall leave them in their rebellion, advancing blindly. Go now. Go as far as you can go. You want to go. We have put a seal on your heart now. You are free to advance in these evils and all these things as far as you like. وَلَوْ أَنَّنَا نَزَّلْنَا إِلَيْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Now because they were demanding miracles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just as he had told the Muslim, وَمَا يُشْعِرُكُمْ أَنَّهَا إِذَا جَاتْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ Now this thing is explained in this next ayah. وَلَوْ أَنَّنَا نَزَّلْنَا إِلَيْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Had we sent upon them the angels, وَقَلَّمَهُمُ الْمَوْتَى Or even the dead people, would have come out from their graves and talked to them. Believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is a true messenger of Allah. وَحَشَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ قُبُلًا And even if we had gathered before them all the things face to face, مَا كَانُوا لَيُؤْمِنُوا إِلَّا يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ They couldn't believe except if Allah permitted. Now because they had gone to that extent of no return, Allah is not permitting them. They will never be permitted now. The seal had been put on their hearts, and curtains had been, you know, thrown before their eyes. We have it in the very first section of Surah Al-Baqarah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةٌ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ. Now they have gone beyond that point. They have crossed the point of no limit. So now all the miracles, even what they demand, if they are shown to them, they are not going to believe. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ يَجْهَلُونَ. Most of them, you know, they are following their passions and emotions. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًّا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ. A very important ayah. And that is why we ourselves appoint for every Nabi, for every prophet, enemies, Satans from the humans as well as the jinn. We ourselves appoint. Could Abu Jahl oppose Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if Allah has not permitted him to do it? Well, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Nobody can do anything if Allah doesn't permit him to do it. Could Abu Jahl oppose him? Could Abu Jahl persecute him? Could Abu Lahab do any harm to Muhammad? Could Umayyah ibn Khalf beat Bilal radiallahu anhu? No. His arm might have been paralyzed the moment he was to strike, you know, Hazrat Bilal. But no. Allah gives them the freedom. Go ahead. Test our believers. Test their courage. Test their steadfastness. Go and test their forbearance. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ عَدُوًا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَىٰ بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفُ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا. They inspire one another with gilded, adorned speech in a deception. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ مَا فَعَلُوهُ. If your Lord had willed, they couldn't do it. And when we believe in it, not even, you know, any leaf can move without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they were permitted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those people who were persecuting. Why? You will find, you know, in the next ayah. فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ. So leave them alone, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and their forgings and concoctions, whatever they are saying. وَلِتَصْغَى إِلَيْهِ أَفْوَدَةُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Why have we given them this freedom? Why this freedom of persecution? Why this freedom of going towards the wrong path? So that the hearts of those who don't believe in hereafter, they incline towards them. You know, you can understand this phenomenon as, you know, electrolysis. Salt is there in a solution form. You pass the current. It is broken into ions. Positive ions going to this side. Negative ion going to this side. Now this process of electrolysis is happening in this society. There is the dawah from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Revelation of Quran is coming. Now whosoever are pure of nature, the right, the positive ions, they will accumulate towards Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whosoever are negative in their nature, perverted nature, they are the negative ions, you know, they have to go to the other side. But if there is no electrolysis, these things will not separate. They will remain as one. So Allah wants that there should be polarization. Those who love truth, they should go to one side. Those who love falsehood, they should go to the other side. And for that purpose, you know, this process of electrolysis and this agitation is going on in this society with the permission of Allah. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ عَدُوًا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ زُخْرَفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ مَا فَعَلُوهُ فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ وَلِتَصْغَى إِلَيْهِ أَفْوَدَةُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. Here again note, the most decisive thing is whether you have some belief in Akhirah. Then you will go to the right side. You are the rightly charged ions. You will go that side. And if doesn't have any fear of Akhirah, any idea of Akhirah, no idea of resurrection, then you know, then you are absolutely lost in this world. Then Quran becomes meaningless for you. the servant of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his dawah becomes meaningless to you. That could have no effect on Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab, etc. Because they were absolutely engrossed and lost in this world and the lusts of this world. وَلَيَرْضُوهُ, so that they may delight in it. وَلَيَخْتَرِفُوا مَا هُمْ يُخْتَرِفُونَ, and so that they should gather and earn what they are gathering and earning. أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ أَبْتَغِي حَكَمًا, again a very searching question. Should I seek another authority, another judge, except Allah? وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكِتَابَ مُفَصَّلًا, it is he who has sent down on you this book, which is very well explained, very fully explained. وَالَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ مُنَزَّلٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ, and those whom the book was given before this book, the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, they very well know that this is the truth from their Lord. As we have read, you know, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ, they recognize Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم just as they recognize their own sons. Nobody can make a mistake in recognizing his son. You know, the Buhaira Rahib, he recognized Muhammad when he was only 11 or 12 years old. And he told Abu Talib, his uncle, take care of this person, this boy, because the Jews, if they come to know, they will harm him. This was the warning from Buhaira. And there were people who recognized him. The Heraclius, Emperor Heraclius, he recognized him. Nagus, he recognized. And about the ulama of Jews, Quran says many a time, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُ, they were waiting for the last prophet. But actually, and they had recognized him. But out of only this jealousy, that he is not from amongst us, they are the biggest racist group in the world. No more racist than Jews. Racist, because this is a racial religion. This is one race. It belongs to one race. They say we are the human beings, complete human beings. All the other who appear to be human beings are actually animals in the form of human beings. They are goyims, they are Gentiles. They are not full human beings at all. So this racism, you know, this that became the hurdle in their way. أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ يَبْتَغِي حَكَمًا وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكِتَابَ مُفَصَّلًا وَالَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ مُنَزَّلٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ بِالْحَقِّ فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُمْتَرِينَ. So you should not be among those who have any doubts, who inculcate any doubts. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا, and the word of your God has reached perfection and completion, both in truthfulness and justice. لا مبدل لكلماته, there is none who can change his words. وهو السميع العليم, he is all hearing, all knowing. وإن تطع أكثر من في الأرض, and if you follow the majority of the people on the earth, يضلوك عن سبيل الله, they will lead you astray from the path of Allah. This is very important ayah, you know. If you believe in popular sovereignty. What does popular sovereignty means? The opinion of the majority should prevail. And Quran says in tute aksara man fil ard. Majority or minority, they are not the criterion of truth. The truth is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down. So the democracy that Islam will have will be limited by the injunctions of the Quran and the Sunnah. Within those limits, you can have a majority vote, no harm. Well, this is also permissible, this is also permissible. Let us decide by majority vote. This drink is also halal, this drink is also halal. Which one we should serve in the party that we are arranging? Well, majority vote can decide it, no harm. But we can't make anything which is haram, even 100% can't declare it to be halal. That authority is not given to any aksariyat, to any majority. In tote, if this majority becomes final verdict, if they have the authority, you will look on Samirillah. They will take you away and astray from the path of Allah. إِن يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا ظَنَّ, because this majority doesn't follow except the conjectures. وَإِنْ هُمْ إِلَّا يَخْرُصُونَ, and they are just guessing. They don't have any knowledge. So the knowledgeable people, you know, who know the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, well, they can decide whether something is halal or haram. That is why I said, you know, in my lecture which I gave on the Islamic structure of the Islamic State, that the parliament has the right to legislate, but within the limits of the Kitab and Sunnah. And whether something has exceeded the limits of the Kitab and Sunnah or not, it will be decided by the judiciary, not the majority. The experts are sitting over here. They will decide whether you have exceeded the limits or not. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ مَنْ يُضِلُّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ مَنْ يَضِلُّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. Verily, your Lord very well knows who has gone astray from his path. وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِالْمُهْتَدِينَ. And he very well knows also those who are rightly guided. فَقُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ بِآيَاتِهِ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Now, in these two ayat, because we have read, you know, there were superstitions in the Arabic society, in the Arabian society. Some animals, you know, because they have been dedicated to such and such thing, and such, you know, this she camel has given birth to so many, you know, children, offsprings, etc. Now they are haram. Now nobody can touch them. Nobody can eat their flesh. Nobody can ride them. So all these superstitions, they were the man-made laws, having no roots in any revealed book, in any law. So even, you know, after becoming Muslims, you know, because these things keep on haunting. Because for so many years, you had the idea in your mind that such and such animals, you can't eat the flesh. So even after having Islam, just as we, you know, people, most of us, we have converted from Hindus to Muslims. And those Hindu superstitions still haunt us. They go on haunting us. And we can, you know, see among our beliefs and at least practices. If, maybe you don't say it out. But, you know, in practice, you remain aloof from those things, you know, which were forbidden in that background from which we are coming. The same was the case for some of the Muslims. Although Quran had declared nothing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not declared anything, any such thing. These things have no roots in the divine law. But even then they were reluctant. فَقُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكَرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ بِآيَاتِهِ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Eat from it. Whatever is halal, as declared by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah's name has been taken over it, so you must eat it. وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكَرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. What has happened to you? What is to you? You don't want to eat on which the Allah's name has been taken? وَقَدْ فَصَّلَ لَكُمْ مَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ. He has already detailed to you what he has made forbidden. You have to abstain from the haram only. Whatever is haram, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained to you. إِلَّا مَسْتُرِتُمْ إِلَيْهِ. Even among from those which are forbidden permanently, if somebody is constrained, there's nothing to eat and he's dying of hunger, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has very leniently and graciously given you the permission to save your life by taking something from that. وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا لَيُضِلُّونَ بِأَفْوَاهِمْ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. But the majority of the people, you know, many of them, they are taking people away from the path of Allah due to their wishes, due to their concoctions. These are their wishful thinkings, without any knowledge, without any basis, without any argument. In رَبَّكَ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِالْمُعْتَدِينَ. And your Lord is very well aware of these people who are exceeding the limits. وَزَرُوا ظَاهِرَ الْإِسْمِ وَبَاطِنَا. And give up, forsake all sins, whether it is in open or it is in secret, hidden or evident. All sins you have to give up. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْسِبُونَ الْإِسْمَ سَيُجْزَوْنَ بِمَا كَانُوا يَقْتَرِفُونَ. Those who are earning sins, they will be recompensed, they will be rewarded, they will be punished for that which they have been gathering and earning. وَلَا تَعْقُلُوا مِمَّا لَمْ يُذْكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْقٌ. And don't eat from that on which Allah's name has not been taken, has not been mentioned. Because that is, you know, that is a rebellion against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now it is for the where willfully, intentionally you don't take the name. But you know, as we have read in Surah Al-Ma'idah, the zabiha, if rightly slaughtered, then the animal which has been slaughtered, which must be permissible in itself, not this wine. Even if you slaughter it, according to the strict Islamic law, it is not going to become halal and permissible. But the goat or the calf, etc., etc., which are permissible to take their flesh. Now, if they are slaughtered by a Jew, a people of the book, or a Christian, but slaughtered in Islamic way, cutting the soft parts of the neck and leaving the spinal cord and the vertebral column intact, then you can take it. Although the name of Allah has not been mentioned on it. But if willfully somebody is avoiding, that means it is wrong. And the Satans, they inspire their friends, their agents, so that they should argue with you. Now, a very interesting argument was, you say this animal died by himself, by itself. It is haram. Who put him to death? Allah. So, an animal put to death by Allah is haram. And whom you sacrifice, whom you put to death, it is halal. How come? This is an argument. So that argument was given. Because they used to eat the flesh of these dead animals. You'll read in Surah An'am also. Even, you know, dead born, even to a she-goat, a dead child is born, or to camel, they used to eat it. So maita, for them, they think it is halal. Allah has killed it. What's the harm? But the Sharia, Islamic Sharia, has declared it to be haram. Why? Because the blood remains in that body, in the tissues. And blood is haram. One of the main things which have been made, which have been prohibited, is blood. وَلَا تَعْقُلُوا مِمَّا لَمْ يُسْكُرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْكُ وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُحُونَ إِلَىٰ أُولِيَاهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ To argue with you. وَإِنْ أَطَعْتُمُوهُمْ إِنَّكُمْ لَمُشْرِكُونَ If you obey them, if you follow them, then you also become associators with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you also become one of them. أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ Now, imagine a person who was dead. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought him to life. But which death? He was dead spiritually. His soul and spirit within him was nearly dead, dormant, asleep, absolute unconscious. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought him to life. Now his soul and spirit is also active. أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَاهُ We have revived him. We have brought him to life spiritually. وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ And we have given him the light with which he is walking. This nur is Quran. His soul has awakened from the slumber. And now Allah has given him the light also. Now he can walk. He will walk, you know, in different aspects of his life. He will act as a Muslim, as a mu'min. So actually, keep this one. Kaman masaluhu fi zulumat. Is this example of this person is like the one who is in darknesses? Laysa bi kharijin minha. And he is not coming out of the darknesses. He wants to remain in the darkness. You know, all the people in the pagan Arabs, they were spiritually dead. Because no prophetic teaching was with them. No Sharia was with them. No book was with them. So actually, spiritually they were dead. But some of the peoples, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he brought them to life. Now they have iman. Their souls are now alive. And now Allah has given them the light, this book, Quran, Sharia. And they are walking in the light of this book. And others are, they want to remain plunged in the darknesses. كَمَنْ مَسَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِّنْهَا ذَلِكَ زُيِّنَ لِلْكَافِرِينَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ In this way, whatever these unbelievers are doing, it has been made beautiful for them. They think we are okay. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا فِي كُلِّ قَرْيَةٍ أَكَابِرَ مُجْرِمِيهَا And in that way, we have appointed in every township, very big criminals, Abu Jahl, like Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab, لَيَمْكُرُوا فِيهَا, so that they go on devising plots against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the same subject, you know, which we read before. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ عَدُوًا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ. In the same way, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا فِي كُلِّ قَرْيَةٍ أَكَابِرَ مُجْرِمِيهَا. You know, the idea could have come to some of the Mu'mins, some of the Muslims of Makkah. Why these people are given this liberty? They are persecuting us. They are leading the people astray, innocent people. They don't know, but they think these are our leaders. They are more knowledgeable. They go to Syria, they go to Yemen, they know this world more than we know. So we have to follow them. So they are leading the silent majority or the common masses. They are leading them away from the path of Allah. So why this liberty has been given to them? So Allah Ta'ala is explaining, this is because we are testing everybody here. Unless there is also evil, evil on one side, good on one side, what is the testing then? If there is no evil in this world, no falsehood in this world, nothing, no sins, then what is, no temptation for any sin, no persecution for going towards right. So what is the, what's your credit then? So that is the philosophy. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا فِي كُلِّ قَرْيَةٍ أَكَابِرَ مُجْرِمِيهَا لَيَمْكُرُوا فِيهَا. So that they should devise plots and schemes, and they should plan how to, you know, forbid people from accepting Iman and faith. وَمَا يَمْكُرُونَ إِلَّا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Whatever they are devising, it is going to be against their own souls. They will be doomed themselves. They will be thrown in the fire of hell. وَمَا يَشْرُونَ. But they don't have the understanding. They perceive not. وَإِذَا جَاءَتْهُمْ آيَةٌ قَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ حَتَّى نُؤْتَى مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ رُسُلُ اللَّهِ. And when signs come to them, now what are those signs? These ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which are being revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They say, قَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ. We will never believe in it. حَتَّى نُوتَى مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ رُسُلُ اللَّهِ. Unless we are given what was given to the former prophets. The miracles, that type of miracle. The visible miracles. The palpable miracles. If you don't show them to us, we are not going to believe. Allah أَعْلَمُ حَيْسُ يَجْعَلُ رِسَالَتَهُ. Allah is more knowledgeable about where to place and at what level to place his messengerhood. Now this ayah, the idea which has come to my mind is that here it doesn't mean that whom to give messengerhood. Because they were not, you know, arguing against the person of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The argument was that we must be given the miracles. So it means the level of messengerhood has been changing. There was a time when humanity was in infancy, in childhood. Children have to be given some toys to play. So they had to be shown these miracles, you know, visible miracles. They couldn't understand things through their intellect, because mentally they were not mature as yet. But now when humanity has come of age, it has become mature intellectually. Now the miracle that has been given to them is the intellectual miracle. Ponder over it, understand it, dive deep into its meaning. It will show you the path. Something within you, your own soul and spirit, will testify to the truthfulness of this book. And you will find a testimony from within you that the source of your own soul and the source of this book is the same. So much is the harmony between human nature and the teachings of this Quran. قَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ حَتَّى نُؤْتَى مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ رُسُلُ اللَّهِ. اللَّهُ عَلَمُ حَيْثُ يَجْعَلُ رِسَالَتَهُ. Now for his messengerhood, he has put a different level. Not of those, you know, which was in the infancy period of humanity. سَيُسِيبُ الَّذِينَ أَجْرَمُوا صَغَارٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Very soon, these criminals who are plotting against Allah and His deen, they will have humiliation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sagarun, humiliation. Wa'azabun sharidun, and very severe punishment. Bima kanu yamkurun, due to these plots that they were devising against the truth. فَمَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَهْدِيَهُ يَشْرَحْ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ. May Allah, may all of us among them, make us من يريد الله whomsoever Allah decides to guide to the right path يشرح صدره للإسلام he opens his heart widens his chest for Islam you know he feels that something within him is readily accepting what Allah is saying this is called opening of the chest شرح صدر من يريد الله به خيرا we have another ayah of this, such verse you know من يريد الله أن يهديه this is the hadith من يريد الله به خيرا يفقه في الدين whomsoever Allah wants to give some good he gives them the deep understanding he gives him the deep understanding of deen in the same way فمن يريد الله أن يهديه يشرح صدره للإسلام he opens and widens his chest for accepting Islam ومن يريد أن يضله and whomsoever he has decided that he will remain on the wrong path يجعل صدره ضيقا حرجا he makes his chest as if it is closed and constricted كانما يصعد في السماء as if he has been made to ascend into the sky he has to strive and he is you know with difficulty he is going up كذلك يجعل الله الرجس in this way Allah Ta'ala puts abomination upon those الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ upon those who don't believe. وَهَذَا صِرَاطُ رَبِّكَ مُسْتَقِيمًا And this is the right path of your Lord, which is straight. قَدْ فَصَّلْنَا الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَذَكَّرُونَ We have explained our ayat to people, for people who want to be reminded. لَهُمْ دَارُ السَّلَامِ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ For them is the house of peace. Abode of peace near their Lord, with their Lord. وَهُوَ وَلِيُّهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ And Allah will be their protector because of the deeds that they have been doing. وَيَوْمَ يَحْشُرُهُمْ جَمِيعًا And just imagine and bring to your mind the time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather them all the jinns, all the humans, they are standing before Him on the Day of Judgment. He will say, Ya Ma'ashar al-Jinn, O community of jinns, قَدْ اسْتَكْثَرْتُمْ مِنَ الْإِنْسِ You begged many from among the humans. You could hunt many. You could beg many. اسْتَكْثَرْتُمْ وَقَالَ أَوْلِيَاهُ مِنَ الْإِنْسِ Now those humans will feel insulted and they would say, رَبَّنَا اسْتَمْتَعْ بَعْضُنَا بِبَعْضٍ Oh, our Lord, we exploited each other. They used us, we used them. They used them, you know, because kahins, you know, they use these jinns to bring the news. And on the basis of those news, on those prophecies, they do business, they have the money. So we exploited them, they exploited us. اسْتَمْتَعَ بَعْضُنَا بِبَعْضٍ وَبَلَغْنَا عَجَلًا الَّذِي أَجَّلْتَ لَنَا And now, the time that we had fixed for us, we have reached that time. قَالَ النَّارُ مَسْوَاكُمْ Allah will say, now, fire is your abode. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا And you will remain in it forever. إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ Except those whom Allah wishes. And who are this exception? Because to the hell will go the unbelievers also, who absolutely rejected the faith. But those of the believers also, whose good deeds were lesser than the bad deeds, they will also be thrown. But then they will be, after having the punishment, the requisite punishment of their bad deeds and sins, they will be taken out. So that is why here is, إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا إِلَّا مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ Verily your Lord is all-wise. And all knowing. وَكَذَلِكَ نُوَلِّي بَعْضَ الظَّالِمِينَ بَعْضًا And in this way, thus we make some of the evildoers as friends of others. They become friends to each other. بِشَيَاتِينَ مِنَ الْجِنِ And شَيَاتِينَ مِنَ الْإِنسِ They become friends to each other. They behave as agents of each other. بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ Due to their earnings, due to their deeds, due to their earnings, they become mutually friends to each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the friendship of shayateen, from among the humans as well as the jinns. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafani wa iyaakum bil ayat wa zikr al-hakim.
Allahu Akbar,
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.